Yo, 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 welcome back to my fishing channel. I got another short video with a couple cool clips that I hope you enjoy. Two of them are of blow-ups, and the third is about a cool new technique. Well, it's not a new technique, it's just a technique I've never used, and it does work, and I'll get to that in 1 second. But first, about the first two clips, and this really isn't an instructional video or anything like that. It's just all about the footage. The only thing I do recommend is always have more than a whopper plopper with you when you're fishing topwater. You don't want to be a one-trick pony. So what I do is I just throw a frog. So I got a frog on deck. Whopper plopper is the main topwater. You could throw the frog into the thick bush, lily pads, whopper plopper you can't. I use a Teckel sprinkler frog, which is essentially as close as you're going to get to a weedless whopper plopper. And with those two videos, the ones that I catch fish with are the whopper plopper, but on the second clip, I get two massive blow-ups on the frog, and then I throw again, and nothing is on the frog. Then I take the whopper plopper out. I throw a little bit to the right. As soon as it hits the water, massive explosion, nice 3-pound bass. So that's the only reason I was talking about two topwaters. You always want to have one on deck, because if you do miss a blow-up and you're able to throw that other lure into a pocket, you might just catch that fish that you missed. Whether or not I caught the same fish that first exploded on the frog, I don't know. But always keep two, because you never know when they're going to come in handy. And like I said, you don't want to be a one-trick pony. The third clip is a technique I've seen online people use. It's where you cast a frog lure over top of a tree branch. So the line's over top of the branch, and you're kind of jigging the frog, just bouncing it off of the top of the water, just making a little splash. And it works. I mean, you've seen the videos online. However, with a GoPro, yeah, it's cool. I got it on tape, but you don't really see much. The view is pretty terrible because you can't zoom with a GoPro, or at least the older GoPros. Maybe with the 6 you can. I don't have a GoPro 6, but you can't zoom, so you can't even see the lure. You do see a fish splash a little bit. So if you're looking to get awesome footage, have someone else come with you with a nice, you know, regular video camera where they can zoom. Because if it does work, you'll get some cool footage for your library. But as far another tip with that, also to make sure it's accessible to get to that tree branch. Because in my case, it got stuck on the tree branch about 3 foot in the air. So I had to be able to get to that tree branch. If I couldn't have got to that tree branch, it would have been a nightmare. But thankfully, the lily pads bush wasn't too thick. My trolling motor was able to get me there. So if you do try that technique, just make sure it's accessible, and the branches that you're able to get there with your boat. And also, if you're looking to get good footage, have somebody with you with a regular camera zoomed in on it. But if you don't care about footage, you know, who gives a crap? It's a fun technique, and it works. Hope you enjoyed the video. Give it a like, subscribe to my channel. If you don't like it, give it a thumbs down. Leave me a comment on why you didn't like it. And that's about it. Good luck fishing, everybody. Have a good one.
Maybe there is. Oh yeah. Another hole. Three pounder. At least. Nice chunk. this might be the 20. Little 3-pounder. I'll take it. A bass midair. Oh shit. Stay on there, boy. That's an interesting catch.